Archaeologist's log. Day 6. Entrance. Morning had broken over the swamp, and I awoke to find myself completely drenched. The hot, humid air of the bog had all but consumed the camp, and I could tell by the look of the crew that they'd been feeling the pinch, same as I. On closer inspection, Martha appeared to be rather pale and exhausted, after clearly having worked through the night. She'd likely been trying to forget about the sudden loss of our fellow crew member, Jonas, the night before. And Bartosz, boasting a rather awkward frown, conflicted, with a hint of a smile in the far corner. Although it was certain that he, too, was anguished over the loss of a good friend. I instructed them both to get some rest, and left the camp for the pyramid. The morning had been particularly warm, making the muck of the swamp slightly more difficult to traverse than the day prior, when we had first arrived. As I approached the structure, my gaze set down once again into the opening. It was no surprise to see that the crew had been working diligently to excavate the tunnel, while preserving as much of the natural beauty as possible. Everything appeared to follow the strict guidelines of the archaeologists' guild. Indeed, it was a commendable effort for such a short-handed crew. I leaned over and unfurled the rope ladder hanging over the tunnel. Cautiously, I took my first steps into the dark abyss. It was hardly dark, I realized, as my eyes adjusted to the magical lighting. That's strange, I thought, as I rubbed my eyes to aid their transition into this new realm. What mysteries were we to uncover here? I found my imagination was running wild over the possibilities. Surprisingly, it had now felt even more humid than that of the already drenched bog above. Mixed with the bright magical lighting, it was the perfect conditions for plant growth. And indeed, these plants had been completely overgrown, to the point where they had consumed the very rock that was the foundation of the structure above. In some cases, plants had been growing right through other plants, due to the lack of space. It was clear that the crew had spent many hours clearing and trimming the bulk and carting it out. Such is life, as an archaeologist. And what's this? A natural cavern filled with seawater? This must be connected to the Brittany Bay to the north. I see the crew have already been making good use of this. Very good use, I thought, as I peered down into the well to see a variety of ocean delicacies. This was certainly very fortunate, and was certain to come in handy during this expedition. I sat down on the makeshift wooden bench that the crew had put together, and took up my rod to help fill our reserves. As I stared into the endless pool, my eyelids became heavy. And my mind began to wander. Thank you.